also got good credentials with her pre-PhD course. And with regard to her teaching experience, she has been guest faculty for 1 year at Gautama Buddha University. And since May 2018 and until now, she is the assistant professor. And she has presented papers in various international and national conferences. And apart from academics, she has also signed in sports. She has played national level javelin throws in schools, and she has won silver medal in inter-university powerlifting competition during her graduation. She has also been the president of her college union during her college studies, and she has also been the NCC C certificate holder. So with all rich credentials and an overall performance, we are very happy to have you here. And now the session is over to you, ma'am. Thank you very
Thank
much.
you. Thank you, Dr. Chandra. So I would like to thank Department of Psychology, American College, Madurai, for giving me opportunity to deliver the lecture in such important series on mental health, which is the need of the hour, as there are so many cases arising on a daily basis only. So we all need to spread word regarding this mental health issues. I would like to extend my gratitude to the patron, Dr. Devamani Christopher, for his support to the series, and also to the coordinator, Dr. Suresh Kumar, who gave me the opportunity to deliver the talk on this webinar series, and also to the Yellow Pond Counseling Center, which are providing the technical support. Without them, it won't be possible for us to connect. I am sitting in UP, and you all are in Tamil Nadu, so just because of this, technical availability, or you can say the internet connectivity, things are possible. So thank you so much. With this, I proceed with my session today. I chose the topic. Just a second, I will share my screen. My slide is visible, I guess. Dr. Chandra?
Yes, ma'am. Your slides are visible.
We can see it.
Okay. Okay. Just a second, I need to. Okay. So I chose the topic positive parenting and mental health. Reason being, as we all know, the initial stages of a child are very, important in the overall development. So I would like to highlight the issue of parenting, which play an important role in overall development of a child, and especially when it comes to the psychological development of a child. So, since I have added mental health also, and the theme of the webinar is also mental health, it's a series on mental health. So, I add this component, mental health. As we all know, the World Health Organization has defined health as, a holistic, which holistic view encompasses physical, mental, and social well-being, and it's not only related to absence of diseases. So, that means mental health is integral part of overall health, and it's really important to talk about it, because everyone, I guess, whenever we encounter with someone, or you can say a group of people, everyone has some or the other issue. So it became more important for every one of us who is in the field to discuss about this thing, mental health. And since it has gained so much attention, and during this COVID, the issues related to mental health problem have arises significantly. So it's really important to talk about the mental health, as NIMHANS has conducted a survey in which they have found that 50 crore people in India are in need of intervention for mental health disorders, and 3 out of 4 person with mental disorders had disabilities affecting their work, family, education, and other aspects of life. So 1 in 20 person in the country suffer currently from depression, out of which 39% suffer from severe depression. So I'm not saying the only cause behind these disorder is, poor parenting style, but yes, initial upbringing of a child have immense, like significant role in the overall development of the personality of a child and how they will going to deal with the problem they encounter in their near future or at their workplace. So the common mental health issues which we often heard from people are depression, relationship issues, and substance abuse, anxiety disorder, stress, emotional breakdown. Yeah, causes are somewhat like studies have already done and are going, and in near future also we all will have several studies. So two important reason which generally comes out in all the studies are biological and environmental. So biological are something which are not in our hand, but environmental factors are in our hand, and we start from them, like family, the environment, or you can say school and the peer group, the team and the where they work, and and it covers individual level. So I've highlighted the family part or parenting part because for me, it may be like according to me, it's really, really important because I have seen so many cases. Or after discussing with so many students, since I'm working, like since past 3 years, I'm working and I'm warden of the hostel as well. So students come up and discuss their issues with me. Somehow they have the root. In like the issues have the root in related to their family issues only, and majorly it is related with the parental aspect. So what is positive parenting? Positive parenting is a parenting behavior based on their best intention of interest of the child, that is their nurturing, empowering, non-violent, and provides recognition and guidance, which involves setting of boundaries to enable the full development of the child. Godfrey has said that all children are born good, are altruistic, and desire to do the right. Means ki no one, I mean all ch children who came who are born with, everyone is born with good intention, and they have the desire to do right. So like we should not treat our children, or you can say children of others also, in a bad way, because it give dent on their mental health. So positive parenting is parenting that foster healthy, protected, and stable emotional bonds. And we as we all know, a child memories last a lifetime. As we also remember such incident which are associated with our childhood, but we still remember because they have they provoke emotions in us whenever we think and sit about it, or in whether intentionally or maybe suddenly, like flash bulb memory we know, and it provokes so much of emotions in an individual. So the memory lasts for a long, whether it is a good one and also a bad one. So what a child needs, the small kid only need the emotional support, the physical touch, appropriate touch, storytelling sessions with which we can teach them what they are supposed to do. We can draw healthy boundaries. Like we should be firm, but we should not be, we should not raise our voice on the child. We should use techniques like time out in appropriate way. We should always encourage the child for the things which he or she came up with. We generally like, yes, the world is really competitive nowadays. Since beginning, a child, so many expectations from parents, you should perform good. Like one of my colleagues, she was teaching her daughter, and her daughter, after 1 hour, she came to her and she started crying. "Mama, I'm feeling that I will not going to recall what I have learned." And she was in LKG. I was little amazed after seeing this thing. So there is lots of expectation from the child that you have to perform good. Then after performing this, you will going to get a gift or so on and so forth. If you like this thing, you will only get. So we parents generally put condition. If you do this, then you will going to get this, which is not the right behavior. The second is phase is like when a child is like little big, the childhood, they become curious, as Piaget has explained, in his stages of cognitive development. So the child is very curious. So yes, we all know we are working, life is really challenging, but we should, we are role model for the children. We should not behave aggressively, we should not show anger to the child if they are curious, since they are in the cognitive development is, speeding up. So they will going to ask so many questions. Like one of the few questions I put here, like they may ask what is corona, and like it is very hit topic nowadays, and will vaccine work or not, so many questions come in their mind. So we should, patiently answer to their question. If the time is not appropriate, we can clearly convey in a polite tone. You may come after, after XYZ. You can give the duration, time, and then we can discuss on this. So the child is curious. We all must, discuss or talk to them, which they really want. And yes, adolescent mental health, so many people, so many, many of us are working in counseling centers, and we have our own counseling centers. So yes, handling adolescents are really challenging nowadays. So we must focus on few things, like give them space and some me time. They have their own personal space. They are growing, so many changes are going with them. So we must respect their, privacy, I can say, or we must give them, a little time, which they generally want. We try to be empathetic towards them. We must share the happy part of their life all along with the unhappy moments, which they are willing to, discuss. So here the question comes, they are willing or they want to discuss. So we must provide the environment, appropriate environment for the child, so that the child is able to discuss whatsoever is coming in his mind. Or her mind. Here, I would like to share one case study. There is one girl, she in engineering. I guess she has passed out now, like completed her engineering. It was an incident I encountered last year. She from somewhere she came to know that I am in psychology, and she the very first word she asked me is, "Ma'am, I hope you will not going to judge me." I said, "No, not at all." Then she start sharing her, what happened with her. She was a victim of, child abuse. She was abused by her own, cousin brother, and in class 6th, which resulted in severe depression. She was diagnosed. Matlab, she told me that was the major reason. Because she was not able to express it to anyone that she has gone through such incident. I asked her, "You didn't even discuss this thing with your mother?" She said, "No." I said, "Why?" Matlab, mother should be the person with whom I guess everyone should be comfortable with. She said she might not have trusted me, or she might not have, taken it so seriously that something such incident can happen, or maybe the brother is, how can a brother be involved? So, and she said, I didn't discuss it. And she had a twin sister who was also doing engineering with her and sharing the same room. I asked her, "Have you discussed this thing with your sister?" She said, "No." I have not even discussed this thing with her, my sister. So I was little amazed, and not amazed, I mean, this was the not only the first case I have encountered. I've encountered two to three cases earlier also in which it has been found that the environment is not provided to the child, that he or she found himself or herself to be, comfortable enough to share anything. So there is urgent need to work upon this thing. There is urgent need to share such bond where the child express everything with their parents, or I can say the primary caregiver, which should not show any non-verbal cue to the child, which hinder or which make the child to become less expressive, and child might start hiding whatsoever. Like if we give them the inappropriate non-verbal gesture, in near future they will stop sharing whatsoever they are willing, or they might think he may upset us or may upset our primary caregiver. They start मतलब दे स्टॉप द शेयरिंग पार्ट, विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज आर चाइल्ड एंड स्पेशली दिस स्टेज एडोलेसेंस इज रियली रियली फ्रेजाइल स्टेट. सो वी मस्ट हैव फ्रेंडली बिहेवियर, वी मस्ट अप्रिशिएट देयर डीड्स, वी शुड नॉट पुट कंडीशन एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड. वी कैन असिस्ट देम इन एक्सप्लोरिंग देयर करियर एज यस दे हैव टू चूज which career to opt for, and we can, yes, screen time. Nowadays, majority of the parents have complained that their child are using phone, they are stuck with the phone. But we have to, we have to set healthy limits, and we have to set boundaries for what in this case we can't, clearly say, or we can't be strict that you are not supposed to use the phone or your laptop. But we can make a timetable in which we can put, there will be a family meeting time in which we will going to discuss this. There will be specific study time, and you have to manage accordingly. So help them develop, this will going to help them develop, conflict management strategies. We have to suffer them, since if we will going to provide them the appropriate environment, the child will be able to, discuss all the issues they encounter, whether it is related to physical abuse or sexual abuse. And yes, you have to guide them in finding an ideal role model which they can follow upon and work accordingly. So there are a few tips I would like to give. Like, we must celebrate the positive aspect and must not put the condition. We must take time to talk, and we have to listen patiently what they are expressing without any non-verbal cue or gesture which may disappoint them or hinder their, ability to express. We must use discipline but not punishment. We must teach them responsibility in a constructive way. We must separate the child from the behavior, or I can say, yes, we must, if a child is behaving in a specific way in certain condition, we can take the child out from that environment. But it is not like that we start, punishing the child, that you are not supposed to do this, now you will not get this and that. No, you can take the child to the other elder environment, or maybe, but the work which you have to do, you have to take the child from the stimulating environment, which is provoking the child to behave in a way which you don't want him or her to. So you have to change the environment. It's not like there is no need to be harsh. Like, I already discussed, the children are fragile, so we must not speak very loudly. Behavior. We must explain things in a logical way. If we are saying that you are not supposed to do this, the reason I am saying so, and there could be n number of factors or result of there may be very bad consequence if you are involved in this thing. We must explain them the consequence logically. Yes, spend quality time with your child and leave the stress of work at home, or sorry, at work only, and you must spend quality time with your children, because that quality time will going to enhance the bond, which is very, very much, the parent-child relationship should be very close. It should very healthy. So give child it input of their decision, what they want to do. You must always assist them in a politer way. If your child wants to do that, you must explain them, okay, fine, you must know the consequence of your decision which you are opting for. And yes, we must be kind. Yes, sometime we need, we should be firm and consistent. There is no need to be louder. There is no need to be, harsh over the child, because they are really, really, soft and going. Already so many challenges are going on nowadays. So we must add positivity, or you can say positive aspect in the upbringing of our children. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Anu Tyagi, for your nice presentation. It was short and sweet. You have given some valuable tips as well. So now the forum is open for discussion. The participants, if you have any questions, kindly unmute your mics or put your questions in the chat box. We can take it forward. Thank you. To begin with, this is Chandra here. I have a question. Can I ask you?
Yeah.
You were telling about the children's memory, which will stay for life. Do we have any proper evidence saying that from which age would it really last longer, or how it works actually? I'm curious to know about it.
So many earlier theorists, or you can say strong proponents of psychology, they have mentioned the critical period. So they have clearly said that initial 5 years of a child are very, very important, which will going to decide, how the child psyche will going to develop. So the initial 5 year of a child should be well treated, and it must have, the child must be handled in a very, very, carefully. Because the memory, or you can say the overall personality of a child gets, developed with this, with the experience which they will going to carry, in their near future. The coping style, the bond between the parents, everything is very crucial. The incident they encounter, initial 5 stages are really important. I hope I have cleared your doubt, Dr. Chandra.
Thank you very much for that. But is it possible to understand from when the child can remember them? For example, I remember very well what happened to me when I was 10 years old. But it's really hard for me to remember what happened at 6.
My daughter,
she remembers what happened to her at 4. This morning, she told me something about that when she was 4 years old.
Chandra, Dr. Chandra, and now I would like to add here. I remember when I was, in class UKG, probably I was 5 or 6 year old. One of my teacher, without my fault, she taught us basic manners of like how to come in the class. And I came out after having water. I came from outside, and I forget. I remember I forgot to, behave in a way she told us to behave. She hit me, and I remember it. And like last week, I was giving class or a session, and I remember, and it was like flashbulb. I remember each and everything of that incident, ki how she behaved and how hardly it, have hit me, and I even told the student, I whenever if I meet her, I will going to convey this thing to her. And like same, you are saying your daughter is 4, my nephew is 3. He will be 3 in, you know, next 2 months. So her mother is work. His mother is working. She took her. She took him along with you know, along with her when he was like 1.2 month old. So these are the evidence I am telling you. So that time he was not able to speak. Language generally developed, clear cut language developed after 2. So he is very, very attached to my mother. That means his grandmother. In night when he is about to sleep, he told one day to his grandmother that I used to, you know, ask my mother that please take me to the home. I don't want to stay here. And my mother was amazed, and she told this thing to me. And I was wondering the state of a child who was not able to, you know, speak, but he expressed that thing after, you know, when he was able to talk and convey the thing. So there are evidences, and these are the clear-cut evidences from our life. But since it's like we all are not that much equipped to assess the memory, you know, the labs are not available, and yes, psychology is still in, you know, infancy stage in India especially. So definitely there is need to, you know, to maybe, matlab, these are the two, like you told about your daughter, she's 4, and I told you about the child who is about to be 3. So studies are ongoing. Yes, definitely these examples will going to, you know, definitely help this thing, yes, ki early memory. It depends on the, you know, the emotion attached to the memory. If emotions are attached, especially the negative one, we will going to remember it.
Very much, ma'am. Actually, my daughter is 9 now, and she remembered things that happened to her at 4. That was really stunning to me. Even I do remember certain incidents when I was younger than 10 years, but still, you know, as I agree with you completely that we can't judge, you know, when the emotions are attached, we remember. That's the normal tendency to anyone, I think. Thank you. And you have got nice comments on the chat box saying that they liked your session. It was wonderful. And we have some questions on the chat box. Could you see it, or shall I read it for you, ma'am?
Oh, just a second. Yeah, I can see one very
question for you starts with what are the parenting techniques and positive parenting techniques, and what are the benefits of positive parenting? It begins there, the first question.
Okay, so generally we like if a child behave inappropriately according to us, like we generally say, the child is not behaving in a behavior which he or she is supposed to. So it's because there are two reasons involved. Maybe we are expecting from them a little more. He or she is not fulfilling our expectation, or maybe the bond between the parent and child is not, you know, have not reached to that level where the child share or each and everything, or, you know, the child is little rebellious. Here I would like to add one example. One class 9 student, he was very good initially in his studies, and suddenly his grade starts falling. He starts securing very bad marks. So the sudden change provoke, you know, thoughts in the mind of the parents. They took the child to the professional counselor, and there he disclosed, I want to hurt my mother as she is not the right lady. And right lady means because he has seen something which is not appropriate or something like that. He disclosed this with the counselor, and he said ki, my mother is not a good lady, and this is the way I want to hurt her. So there are so many reasons why a child start behaving, you know, in a deviated way. So we must, you know, must share that bond first of all, where the child should express the good and bad, the moment of happiness as well as unhappiness. Yes, there are several techniques like time out, but it should be used in an appropriate way. Like generally, if we as a counselor tell our clients that you should, you know, take the child out from the environment which stimulate the child to behave in a way in which according to you is inappropriate. So that doesn't mean that you lock the child or isolate the child. No, you have to take the child in a less stimulating, or you can say to that place where the child, you know, can not behave, you know, or must not get that type of stimulus which is provoking the child to behave, you know, in a certain way.
Thank you, ma'am. There is one question. What is the best parenting advice you would say?
Best, expect less, don't put condition, and try to listen your child. If you will going to provide them, you know, and yes, do keep a check on your non-verbal cues. They are very, very important. If your non-verbal cues, yes, say for example, if a child is sharing something and you made a face which is inappropriate, or you are showing less or no interest, or you know, you raise your eyebrow, so that thing, you know, a pinch, or you can say stop, definitely, matlab, the child will going to, you know, as we have already, we studied this thing, non-verbal cues or gestures are more important than the verbal ones. So they have very strong effect. The child may stop expressing, or may think that you are not liking what you are sharing. So you should always have that sort of expression which you know, which give them that you are not judging them.
We see another interesting question from a participant. He's mm-hmm. asking this question on behalf of his mother. The okay. question is, okay. what if the mother finds his son has a girlfriend? How would she react? How should she react? Sorry, how would she is not the right way. How should she react?
So I would like, yes, I would like to first, matlab, thank you for the question. So matlab, we are living in 21st century. I don't think so. It is a big, you know, big deal to have a girlfriend or a boyfriend nowadays. But yes, generation, the parents must be psycho-educated in, you know, how they have to act if they encounter such thing. In this, we can tell them ki it's not the things are changing. It's because now the accessibility have increased, because in their time, the child, you know, they might not be exposed. The female were not supposed to, you know, study much, and they should be confined. But now the thing has changed. Here, what you can do, you can't stop the child to have, you know, to be in such relationship, but you can tell the limits which they have to follow. And again, I'm saying that if you will going to provide the appropriate environment to the child, they will going to share their things directly. They will not going to hide it from you. And if they will going to share, you can convey your concern. Can this is what I am concerned of. You are, you know, you are in a growing stage. This is not the appropriate time to be in such thing. You can delay, or you know, or if you want to be in such thing, then you must have clear cut boundaries, and your study should not be affected.
Very well said, ma'am. One last question for today is, what yeah. are the best practices or techniques for restructuring or changing the distorted cognitive imprints of memories during the teenage, if found an appropriate if found an appropriate change required? So for restructuring or changing the distorted cognitive imprints of memories.
Yeah, distorted, you know, like the word itself says, distorted one. So here, if you know something which is pinching, or you know, which is bothering us, there is need to express it. Again, the question of expression comes, and for that we need to provide the environment. If the child will going to express their thing, what they have felt, if I have behaved, say for example, if I'm a mother and I have behaved in, you know, in a way which, you know, which affected my child badly. So if environment is, you know, apt, or I have provided my child that sort of environment in which he or she is comfortable of sharing things, he will going to convey me ki, look, mummy, this is not the way, or I got hurted and I really felt bad. So if yes, if the conflict is resolved on the spot, it will not going to, you know, have long lasting effect. If they have the long lasting effect, then yes, again the expression part will going to play the most important role. You must ask your child ki what's wrong, and you must clarify the reason. You must give them, you know, valid reason for why you have, you know, behaved in such way. If they will going to get the reason or the consequence, it will be right.
Thank you, ma'am. Seriously, this is going to be the last question, because that I found it interesting again. How to amend a child for repeating a wrong behavior even after being told repeatedly with the right behavior?
Can you repeat it again?
A child is repeating a wrong behavior, mm-hmm, even after being told with the right things. How do we amend that child?
Yeah. So I have already given the answer of this question. It is like, either we are not listening to the child, or we are expecting more with the child. Maybe the behavior which he or she is doing, just a second. Yeah, maybe if the child is doing or performing something which according to us is inappropriate, we must ask the child, or we must ask the explanation, or we can ask why he or she is, you know, behaving in such way. And like I have discussed one of the case study, the child is, you know, continuously doing so because he want to hurt her mother. So we need to work on the, you know, the consequence part, ki why, or you can say the we must need to go to the root of the why he or she is behaving so. Yes, and the child is, if the child is hiding something from us, then it means the relationship between the parent and child is not developed up to that extent where the child is comfortable in sharing things. Or we are putting, and the second reason is, we are not putting the realistic expectation from the child. Maybe if we say ki our child must crack IIT examination or AIIMS, and our child is not, you know, that her or his ability is not meeting up to that condition, so this is really wrong to expect such thing from a child.
Thank you very much, ma'am. So sweet of you. You have been answering very patiently and very clearly.
Thank you so much.
And personally, I have learned a lot today. Thank you for that. And now I would request Dr. Saleem to give his gratitude for your nice session, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Sandra, ma'am. I'm audible, ma'am.
Yeah, you are audible.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. It was a very wonderful session we had it today in the topic of positive parenting, mental health, actually. So I'm mental health. So we had a 332 session today. So it was a very good session, ma'am, by you. You elaborately explained, and the short and sweet presentation you made it in all the aspects you very clearly mentioned. We learned a lot today. Like what child needs in the respect to, there are a lot of tips, strategies given by you. Definitely we will be using the tips because every family, they have a child, they will use the tips for that. Of course, in recent data by Ministry of Youth Development, in weight population, I think 20% of total weight population belongs to the age group of 10 to 19, adolescent age group. So it is a very big strength. As you said, the spinal cord, the child's memory lost a lifetime. So we have to mold it very carefully because all the cells are born good. That's what we imported today. So that 20% of the population, we have to grow positively, and they are going to be the leader tomorrow. So as you mentioned, they need it actually emotional support from the parents or peer groups or whatever. So and of course encouragement, all those things. These are things given by the parents, and definitely we have a lot of tips given, like giving them space. And of course nowadays due to some situations that they are not giving the space in some family. But I can say there are a lot of people, they are not very empathetic to their children. That is the worries actually. So they have to be empathetic with the child, and having friendly behavior. And we had a question answer also in detail this thing. So in relationship, there was a study stating that every 7 years the relationship changing. Like father and son, after 7 years they are becoming the friend. So in the aspect, definitely relationship will change, and it will not grow, it will be, the bonding will be more. So you have to be more the children's very happy with the positive effect you mentioned, talking to them nicely and celebrate with the positive aspect, action speaking love with the words, using natural logic, it comes to a lot of things. Thank you, ma'am. Thanks for the wonderful session. Thank you all the participants. Kindly accept our gratitude on behalf of American College Madurai and the MS Chellamurthy Institute Madurai and the Negro School of Social Work Chennai and the Red Pond Educational Psychology Research Center Madurai, Psycho-Oncological Association, Turkey. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you all the participants. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Salim. It was a really nice to deliver the talk with such wonderful participants.
One Mr. Ashwin has volunteered to give his gratitude to you. Kindly accept that as well. Mr. Ashwin, you can kindly unmute your mic and just talk a few words about today's session.
Audible?
Yeah.
Very good evening. That was a wonderful and very interactive too. Again, small micro learning in our sessions to Madam, regards to non-verbal communication influence and two case study. It is really astounding. Really heartfelt thanks to you for organizing, being a resource person, and literally thanking American College and especially Coast for this wonderful things happening. Thank you so much. Happy New Year, Madam.
Oh, thank you so much, Ashwin.
Thank you, Mr. Ashwin, for your kind words again. And I think, Anu ma'am, we are winding up today's session with this.
Okay, thank you so much.
We thank you once again for everything for this evening. And
Okay, thank
thank the
you. Thank you
participants
so
for
much.
supporting us. And we will see you tomorrow in yet another session, the same time. Bye bye.